Dear students, Salaam Alaikum. This is experiment number 5, projectile motion for the course Physics 170L Introductory Physics Laboratory for the semester Spring 2020-2021. In this experiment, we shall study the projectile motion using a projectile launcher. As usual, we'll have two videos. One video is from the lab, and one video is what you are watching from my notes. Now, what is a projectile? The simplest example of a projectile is a football being kicked. When the football is kicked, it goes up and comes down. Now, the trajectory of a football is not a straight line, definitely. It's also not part of a circle. It's part of a parabola. A second degree equation generates a parabola. For example, y equal to ax square plus bx plus c, and these abc constants come from your initial velocity, from the angle of the launch, and most importantly from the acceleration due to gravity. Now, in the lab we shall be using a projectile launcher. It looks like this. You can adjust the angle, you can adjust the speed. It has three notches: medium speed, high speed, and low speed. In today's experiment, we shall be sticking to the low speed. There are two parts. In the part one, we shall do a horizontal launch from the table to the ground. And in the second part, we shall adjust to an angle of 25 degrees. Why we choose 25 degrees? This is an optimum angle, and you'll see it why it is optimum. Now, the thing which we'll be launching will be these yellow colored plastic balls, which are smaller than the tennis balls, and we'll be using notch 1, which has the minimum speed. The launch angle can be adjusted very accurately using this plumb line and a hanger, hanging mass, which will act as a plumb line, and it is straightforward to do this experiment. Now, before we do the experiment, we shall do one numerical problem in order to understand the calculations needed for this experiment. Now, let's read out the problem. A ball is launched horizontally with a speed V0. Sometimes we say V0. Not means zero. The launcher is at a height of Y0 equal to 120 centimeters. The horizontal distance traveled by the ball is X0 equal to 160 centimeters. Part 1. Find the initial velocity V0. Part 2. The same launcher is used to launch the same ball at an angle of 25 degrees. Theta equal to 25 degrees. Calculate the horizontal range of the ball. The launcher is on the ground. Now let's look at the schematic diagram. In part 1, the launcher is at a height on the table. So the total height will be the height of the table plus the small height of the launcher. The launcher has a height of about 15 to 20 centimeters. When you launch the ball horizontally, it will fall at some distance. This distance has to be measured accurately. I'll tell you how. And it is 160 centimeters in this problem. Now, after you get the velocity of the launcher, you will launch it at an angle. In the first part, it is horizontal, and in the second part, it will have an angle of about 25 degrees. So you have to measure the range given in red here. Again, it is a parabola, as I told you. Now, these are your part 1 and part 2 of the experiment. Let's look at the problem again. Now, there is no acceleration in the horizontal direction. Your gravity acceleration is only in the vertical direction, and its magnitude is 9.8 meters per second square. Do not use any other number or any other unit. Now, all these calculations have to be done in meters and seconds. Now, the height is 120 centimeters. Divide by 100, you will get 1.20 meters. Now, the time to land on the ground will depend on the height, not on the x direction, because the acceleration is in the y direction, and the time is square root of 2y0 by g. This is your second kinematics equation, and these kinematic equations you have seen in physics 100 and physics 170. If you don't recall them, look at them now. Your equation is y equal to y naught plus half at square plus vit. So this is the delta y, the total height which it has traveled. So t equal to 2 y naught by g under the root. Y naught equal to 1.2, 2 into 1.2 is 2.40 divided by 9.8. You'll get 0.244. Take the square root, you'll get 0.49 seconds. Do not round off any number. Take three numbers after the point or at least two numbers. Now in the horizontal direction, there is no acceleration. You have the ordinary equation, speed equal to distance by time, v naught equal to x naught by t, 1.6 divided by 0.49, you'll get 3.26 meters per second. So knowing the height of the launcher, which you can see in the diagram, in the horizontal range, you can calculate the speed with which the projectile is launched in part 1. After you get the speed in the part 1, then use your regular projectile motion equations. The range given in red in this diagram is r equal to v naught square sine 2 theta. It is the sine of the double angle divided by g. It is not 2g, it is single g. 3.26 whole square into sine 2 into 25. 2 into 25 is 50 degrees. Change your calculators to degrees. Do not use radians here. 3.26 square will be 10.62, sine 50 is 0.766. Multiply these two numbers, divide by 9.8, will get 0.83 meters. Now calculations have to be in meters, but in the lab we use a centimeter scale sometimes. So multiply with 100, it is 83 centimeters. Or you can put one more number and get something like 83 points. You have to use degrees and not radians. Look at the units of the angle, it is degrees. So in part 1, we get the velocity, and in part 2, we get the launch. Sorry, the range. Same thing will happen in the experiment. The aim of this experiment is to study the projectile motion, measure it in the lab, the range, and compare it with the mathematical value. What apparatus do you need? You need the projectile launcher, plastic balls, plumb bob. The plumb bob will help you to hit exactly horizontal or 25 degrees or some other angle as needed. Meter stick, also called as meter scale. Carbon paper and white paper. Now why we need carbon paper? Now let's look at the diagram again. This is the launcher, the ball is going. The ball will fall somewhere on the ground or on the table. Now you have to know the exact position where it has fallen. So one method of doing it is use a camera. But we are not going to use a camera. We'll be using a traditional technique. We'll put a white paper on the ground and fix it. So first we'll launch the ball several times. We'll know the approximate position. Fix a white paper there. And on the white paper, put the carbon paper. So use a fresh white paper. If your carbon paper is black coated, it will give a black dot. If it is blue coated, it will give a blue dot. You can get it from the stationery shop. So in part 1, the launcher will be at a height on the table and the ball will fall on the ground. Or you can make it fall on the table also, but it is better to do it on the ground. Table to the ground, because we need a good height of 1 meter. Otherwise, these measurements are difficult. Mathematically, you can do it for even for small heights, but in lab, it's better to do it for about more than 1 meter, what we saw in the problem. In part 2, you can fix the launcher on the table, put it at 25 degrees and make it fall, but it should be at the same level. If it is not at the same level, the equations will be difficult. So in order to avoid difficult equations, we'll put it at the same level by putting a stand here, not a box. And this stand will be like the jack of the car, which is used for changing the tires. So you can adjust the height. The launcher and the paper should be at the same height. So you put this stand here, adjust the height since till both are equal, then put the white paper on the launcher and you can adjust the position of the white paper so that the ball should fall on it most of the time. Not all the time, most of the time. In the first part, the launcher will be on the table and you measure the total height because the launcher has its own height and the height of the table. Two together will be the full height. In the part two, you do it from table to table or ground to ground. If you do ground to ground also, you have to put the launcher rigidly on the ground with the help of a clamp. And you'll have to not keep a box here. You can keep that jack-like stand and adjust the distance so that the ball falls on it. And on the white paper, you fix the carbon paper. You can fix the white paper with a tape because when the ball falls or the wind is coming from the AC or something, it moves. Better to switch off the AC and the fans. What formula do we need? T equal to under root 2y naught by g. And for part 1, we need one formula for the velocity, which is x0 by t. And part 2, we need only one formula. The range, the horizontal range is v0 square sine 2 theta by g. And the angle has to be in radians. The horizontal acceleration is 0. The gravity does not shift things to the left or to the right. The gravity is up and down. So, vertical acceleration is g. The magnitude is 9.8 meters per second square. Sometimes we write plus g, sometimes we write minus g, depending on the situation. And that you should know what to do from your kinematics equations. Now, the theory you can read. Now, what's the procedure? I'll explain you the procedure with the help of a table. And you can watch the two videos, one from the lab and one from the notes. Now, please pay attention. This is the table and the yellow is your data. Now, the vertical height you will measure one time. Height of the launcher, 15-20 centimeters plus height of the table, it is 1.145 meters. Write it in meters. If you are measuring in centimeters or millimeters, do it outside the table. In the table, just write the height in meters, y0. Now, what about the horizontal? See, the horizontal distance has two parts. Which are the two parts? The big distance from the table to the white edge of the white paper, and you'll have a small distance inside the white paper. So please pay attention. Start with the second row of the table. Horizontal distance to the edge of the paper. Not the corner, it is the edge of the paper, the side of the paper. So measure the distance, that will be a big number. Then the ball will fall many times, sometimes on the outside the paper, sometimes inside the paper. Take 5 dots inside the paper, then measure the small distance inside the paper from the same edge which you are using in your big distance measurement. Measure the small distances, they will be in centimeters. Take the average. The average of these numbers, the smallest is 5, the biggest is 13, the average is 8.5. This is centimeters divided by 100, you will get 0.085 meters. Now, the distance to the edge of the paper is 1.455. So, this yellow distance plus this small average red distance, add both of them, you'll get the average distance of the ball falling on the paper is 1.54 meters. You can measure directly from dot to the table, but we avoid that. Because you measure the big distance one time and the small distance 5 or 10 or 20 times and take the average of the small distances and add. Now in the experiment, the ball will not always fall on the paper. Fix the paper, it will fall sometimes outside, sometimes inside. Just count the distances inside. And the distance will be varying much. You will not get similar numbers. Look, one is 5, one is 13. 13 divided by 5 is 2.6. It's a big difference. It's not like 5 and 5 and a half and 6 and 4.9, 5.1. It will not happen with this projectile launcher. There are reasons for that. Now this yellow is your data, black and red are your calculations. Do all the calculations outside the table. Inside the table, just write the answer. If anybody does any calculations inside the table, marks will be cut. I'll not read the calculations. Once you do it inside the table. Do it outside. Don't show me the calculations, just show me the number. I know how to calculate and check your answers. Now first calculate time of flight, t equal to 2y0 by g under the root, 2 into 1.145, we'll get 2.29 divided by 9.8. will get 0.2333. Take three numbers after the point, take square root, will get 0.48 seconds. Now, this small distance is 0.085 meters. Remember to use meters, and your average distance x0 is how much? Distance from the edge of the paper 1.455. It will become more because you are adding a small number to it. So 1.455 plus 0.085 will get 1.54 meters. Average velocity. Why it is average velocity is because we have measured the distance 5 times. In the problem, we measured it one time. Here it is 5 times. Now the average is 1.54 divided by 0.48. x0 divided by t, it is 3.20 meters per second. Your speed from the launcher will be approximately this. Different students will get different speed. It is okay. Now after you get this, now go to the part 2. Part 2, it is 25 degrees. Part 1 was horizontal. Horizontal distance. Learn to read the English inside the table. Then it is at 25 degrees. Horizontal distance is 0.69 meters. Again, measure the distance from the launcher to the edge of the paper. Fix another new paper or same paper, you use the other side, and note down which is for the 25 degrees, which is for the horizontal. Because those students who are coming to the lab in the campus will have to attach this paper to the lab report. Those who are not able to come will be able to do it, take the data from here. A predicted range. This is your mathematical range. R0 equal to V0 square sine 2 theta by G. We are not calling it R, we are calling it R0. V0 square, 3.2 square into sine 2 into 25. 2 into 25 is 50. 3.2 square is 10.24 exactly. Into 0, 10.24 into sine 50. Sine 50 is 0.766. Now divide by 9.8. You will get 7.84 divided by 9.8. You will get 0.80 meters. This calculation has to be in meters, and the answer will be automatically. Now, distance from the edge of the paper to the point where the ball falls, dot by the carbon paper. This will be a small distance inside the paper. How big is your paper? Paper is 15, 20, 30 centimeters. You'll get some small distances. The smallest is 6 and the biggest is 14.5. Look, you cannot get a very accurate numbers with this launcher. You need a different kind of launcher. Take the average of these numbers. It will be between 6 and 14.5. It is 9.2. Centimeters. Divide by 100, you will get 0.092. Now the distance from the edge of the paper is 0.69 meters. Add it, you will get a new number. 0.69 plus 0.092, you will get 0.782 meters. Now this is your lab range. This is what you are getting by measuring the 5 dots on the paper. Your mathematical thing is 0.80. Now do the percentage error. It is R0 minus R divided by R0. The mathematical result is perceived to be more accurate. So you do it 0.8 minus 0.782 divided by 0.80. Take the absolute value, because sometimes this number will be negative, not in this calculation, but in some other calculations. So the percentage error is positive. So take the absolute value, what we call it as mutlak in Arabic, into 100. You'll get 0.18 divided by 0.8. Into 100, you will get 2.25%. The error in this kind of experiment is about 3-4-5%, not more than that. You have to do the experiment carefully, switch off the AC while the ball is in the motion. So these two calculations are similar to what we have done in the problem. In the problem, we had one data, here we have 5 data, so we take the average in both the tables. And remember, it is the distance to the edge of the paper, then the small distance inside the paper. Some people will try to measure it directly from the dot to the launcher, but that is not very accurate. It is better to measure to the edge of the paper, then the small distances are easy to take the average. Both are fine. But in the data, it is inside the paper, so you have to manage as given in the data. Now do the calculations. No calculations inside the table. Do them outside. I don't want to see your calculations. I just want to see these red numbers over here. That's it. Your teachers will do their own calculations to check your tables. So you do it outside the table or inside the calculator or inside the mind or on your fingers. Do not send me picture of your calculators and fingers. I am not interested. Now the calculations are same as the problem we have done in the experiment. There is no graph in this experiment. Please base the graph. This is only the white paper with the carbon dots. Attach it to your report. What's the resultant conclusion? The projectile motion is studied using the projectile launcher. The predicted horizontal range is similar to the measured value within experimental errors. That's it. What are the references you need? This is a very good reference on projectile motion from Wikipedia. Then there are two references from PASCO manual. Please go through them. Submit the complete report in two parts. One part is your one page theory, 200 words, 250 words in MS Word. Do not send me any PDF file, only MS Word. And submit it in Moodle, and one is the full report. You can watch more videos on this channel. Now, what about the data for the lab? Look at the data for the lab. You have the vertical distance. Somebody measured it for you. You have the horizontal distance to the edge of the paper. Now calculate T here. Do not leave anything empty. In the first few reports, people have left things empty. Somebody has to calculate them. Calculate the T. Look at the problem. Then take the average of these five numbers. You'll get the average distance inside the paper. And the full average distance will be this small number in centimeters divided by 100, added to 1.51. You'll get the complete x0. And then take the average velocity. You know the time. You know the average horizontal distance x0 divided by t. No calculations inside the table. Then once you finish part 1, then you go to part 2. The angle is how much? 25 degrees. Read. It's not always 25. It can be any number. So read, it is 25 degrees. And the horizontal distance is a new distance. Because when you put the angle, the range will change. When you change the angle. So the good distance for the edge of the paper is 0.80 meters. And now again, the thing will not do the mathematical calculation here. You do not need this five datas here. R0 can be calculated directly from 25 degrees and 0.8, and V0 is in part 1. Use V0 from table 1. Read the English of the table. Then measure the average of these 5 numbers in centimeters divided by 100. You will get something in meters here, some small number. And add it to 0.80. You will get the value of R. Then do this percentage error calculations. That's all you have to do and submit your report. It's not much. It can be this kind of report can be finished in 1 hour. Calculations will not take more than 5-6 minutes. We'll discuss these things again in the class if needed. Inshallah, see you soon in the class. Assalamu alaikum.